Today we'll discuss on the topic that is electrostatic potential energy. Actually, this is given by the symbol capital U. We have already discussed about electric charge, electric field, electric potential. Now we will discuss about electrostatic potential energy. One thing you keep in mind that electrostatic potential energy is actually calculated for a system of charges. When we say system of charges, we mean at least two charges. Single charge will have no electrostatic potential energy, but single charge can produce a electrostatic potential. Means if there is a charge, here we can find out V, we can find out electrostatic potential. Here also we can find out electrostatic field or electric field, but here we cannot find out electrostatic potential energy. We will have electrostatic potential energy if at least two charges are there. Okay, so that means the concept is like this. Suppose we have two charge system like this Q1 and Q2. They are placed at a distance R apart from, it means R apart. Then this system will have the potential energy given by the concept that work done in arranging these charges in their respective positions. We will imagine as if these charges are not here, they are at infinity. Let us say we have brought first charge from infinity to this point. So the concept says, when we bring this charge from infinity to this point, as there is no other field, so we have to do no work. But to bring the second charge from infinity to this point, we have to do some work. So whatever work we do in arranging these two charges in their system, in their respective positions, becomes the potential energy of the system. So for this system, the potential energy will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R. Keep it in mind, if we will find out force between these two, it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. But this potential energy, almost similar, you see here, instead of R square, we have R here. But another thing you keep in mind, if both the charges are positive, then potential energy will be positive. Similarly, if both are negative also, we will get potential energy of the system to be positive. If one of them is positive and the other is negative, then the potential energy of the system will be negative. Now we will derive this formula of the potential energy of these two charges. Q1, Q2 are there. Just now I have told that to bring Q1 from infinity to this point, to bring Q1 from infinity to this point, we are doing no work. Now we have to bring Q2 from infinity to this point. Suppose that Q2 is kept here at a distance, let us say at a distance x from this point. Okay, so in this case, you see Q2 is brought from infinity. Ultimately it will be kept here, but at a moment it is kept at this point and the distance is x. So in this case the work done is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by how much? The force will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by x square, and to displace it by a small amount dx, let us say, so we have to do the work done dw, that is equal to f dx, that is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by x square dx. This much work we have to do in displacing Q2 from this point to this point. Keep in mind, ultimately we have to shift, or we have to bring that charge from infinity to this point. So now the total work done W will be integration of this f dx from infinity to R, and this will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, q1, q2 will be there. So this one x to the power minus 2 dx, then infinity to R. This is equal to q1, q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0, then this one will be x to the power minus 1 by minus 1, infinity to R. Now, you see, if you put the value, and this will be equal to, W will be equal to q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0, then minus sign will be there, this minus sign, x to the power minus 1 is 1 by x, this is infinity to R, okay. Then this will be minus q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0, 4 pi epsilon 0, this will be 1 by R minus 1 by infinity. You see, one thing we have missed here, while bringing the charge from infinity to this point, okay, the force was towards that and the displacement was towards this. So a minus sign, a minus fdx was actually there, so that minus we have missed. So this minus sign is there, so this minus will be there, and ultimately this will be plus, this will be plus. So finally we will get q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r. Okay, so this is the work done in arranging these two charges in their respective positions, q1, q2, distance between them is r. Okay, and this is actually equal to the potential energy of these system, means this system. So this is called u12. If this is charge number 1, this is charge number 2, then the potential energy between these two charges, or the potential energy of this system, is equal to q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r. Now just another point I want to clarify here. Suppose we have two charges q1 and q2, distance between them is r. Okay, if we find out force between these two, it will be equal to this q1 q2 by r square. Keep it in mind, this force is a vector quantity, but we are calculating the magnitude of force, that becomes equal to this. But if you find out the potential energy of this system, it will be equal to q1 q2 by r. See, very much similar. And the last point in this is, suppose we have a charge q here, at a distance r from this charge, the electric field will be given by this formula, q by r square. You see here, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r square. And the direction part, you know, if it is positive charge, it will be away from this. If it is negative charge, it will be towards this. But to find out the potential at this point due to this charge, this will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. In this case also, if the charge is positive, the potential here will be equal to positive. If the charge will be negative, then potential will be negative. You see, the very similar formula, but slight difference is there. So we have calculated actually FEBU, so to say, in short, FEBU. Okay, F is force, E is electric field, V is potential, and U is potential energy. Then you can solve some problems based on this, so that you will have the clarity of the concept regarding these four terms. Thank you.